to say that. We are finally together. Welcome to the only season finale I can think of this week. This is HQ Words season 3 finale. It's going to be a party. We're a little late tonight, but hey, it's fine because we're giving away the biggest prize ever, okay? For some of you, this could be your third and final chance to win some major money on HQ tonight. And you know what they say, third time's a charm, especially after 10:30. Am I right? I'm right. I am your host, your charming word queen. It's me, Anna Roisman. You can follow me here all over social media. Do you know that we are about to make history? We're making history tonight with the biggest prize yet, at the latest time yet, and I love it. Tonight I'm gonna show you 15 puzzles. Ooh la la. And for this special supersized game, each puzzle is like worth $1K because we've got $15,000 as our prize tonight. You could buy yourself a brand new car. Come on down. All right, maybe not a car, but let's dream big. I'm dreaming big tonight, you should be too. Tonight you're gonna get 5 strikes, plus whatever strikes you already have from leveling up this season. It is time to spin that lucky letter wheel. Since this is such a special night, I wanted to give you the best letter of all, and that's a love letter. Dear word nerds, roses are red, violets are blue. I hope you take home a piece of the prize with you. Oh, you know what? I'm good with words, it's true. Also pure coincidence, but according to the internet, it's National Millionaire Day. Did you know that? You're on your way. It's time for the first puzzle. The faster you solve, the more points you can earn. It's about to go down. Not this game, no, we're playing again, we're playing now. Your first hint is very special attire. Type in the letters D, G, and W. This is something you would wear on your special day. Or if you're like me, you would go to a store with a friend and try these on just for fun, just for the Instagram. Very special attire. You can even buy one and return it if it's, you know, I'm talking about a wedding gown! Ooh, a wedding gown. If only I hosted tonight in a wedding gown, I would feel like I'm getting married. 135,345 solved the puzzle, 12,639 were left at the altar. Hey, I know you already know this, but have you heard on Wednesday night, we are having dog night. Who let those dogs out? Oh gosh, I could watch these dogs all day. We're gonna have dog trivia, dog words. It's gonna be so extremely fun. Eric Stone Street is gonna be in the house, guest hosting that night. That's very cool. All right, are you excited for Memorial Day weekend? I am. Maybe you have a barbecue plan. Maybe you've got a beach trip planned. Here's a sweet beach activity. This is something that you really put your whole self into. It's pretty active for the beach, right? I like to watch this, but I'm more of a lay in the sun, fall asleep kind of beach person. But this is a cool beach activity. And the answer is bodyboarding. Oh yeah, it's like surfing, but you're on your stomach and you're boarding through the waves. 103,441 solved the puzzle. 32,683 eliminated on bodyboarding. Look, if it's not nice enough to go to the beach this weekend, you might stay inside and watch something good. How about this TV juggernaut? Say that word, juggernaut, it's fun. This is a show that people do not like to stop talking about. It's been around for a while, but it's just one of those shows where if you don't watch it, you're totally out of the conversation. But it's pretty impressive when you make it to 10 seasons, something to talk about. Better run and watch this, because I'm talking about The Walking Dead. Run to The Walking Dead, she said. 100,447, you are still hot in this game. You are still gliding through. 6,693 eliminated on The Walking Dead. You ever walk aimlessly around in a new city because you're lost, and then you realize, actually, this is a great way to learn about this place. Nope, just me? Okay. Anyway, what is this famous landing spot? No one actually walked here, but they landed here via another type of transportation. It's a place we talk about but once a year when we think back on the history of a certain holiday. Famous landing spot. The answer is Plymouth Rock. Plymouth Rock, it's where the Pilgrims landed. I just turned into a football player. They came to here to Plymouth Rock. We talk about it every year on Columbus Day. 81,216 got it right. 19,000 eliminated. Did you know, I read this today, Plymouth Rock actually broke in half. It did. The only thing I can think of, you know, of someone who might be able to break a rock in half like this would be a large mammal. Maybe the Pilgrims came across this large mammal on their journey. This is a mammal that you don't see every day unless you live near a large body of water. Ooh, good hint. It has a very unique shape to it. And this large mammal, it grunts and moans a lot. It does. I'm talking about a humpback whale. Ooh, look at that humpback whale. Showing off its beautiful humpback whale body. 73,197 got it right, 11,000 eliminated. And here's a good dad joke for you. What's a humpback whale's favorite day of the week? Wednesday, cause it's hump day. All right, thanks, yeah. I'll just take my golf bag and head on out of here. Hey, can I get philosophical for a second? Life is full of surprises, but in the end, it all evens out. It's beautiful, namaste. This is a saying that explains this idea. Whether you're playing a game like HQ every night, or I don't know, if you're gambling, you're living a wild life, hopefully it works out. But remember, nothing is perfect. Steady, we can strive for. But the answer is, you win some, you lose some. It's the name of the game. You win some, you lose some. Hopefully tonight you're gonna win some. 51,948 are still on their way. 23,475, you'll lose some tonight, but it's okay, we're live every night. You can come back for another night and you'll win there. When I found out that tonight's supersized prize was $15,000, I fell over. No, I didn't really, but I said, finally! Finally! A big treat for the word nerds. It's exciting. This is exciting. I'm very excited. This is something that an optimist would say. When you've been waiting for something and then it arrives, oh, it feels so good. Regardless of the timeline, finally, you have it. And it's just like how the game began tonight. Better late than never, right? Better late than never. You're still going home with money tonight, and we're still playing a game, and we're live. 51,594. Better late than never. You got it right. Moving on to puzzle 8. I'm a big supporter of YOLO because it's true, right? I want to know this risky behavior. We're living on the edge tonight, right? You only get one life. You only get one chance in this world. You might as well take some risks. Risky behavior. Maybe this is a new move for you, which is very exciting, very scary, all in one place, but that's what taking risks is all about. It's about going out on a limb, right? Maybe it's not something you do every day. You're gonna go out on a limb. You're gonna try something new, you're gonna take a risk. 45,658 got it right, 7,266, we say goodbye. I'm gonna go out on a limb and say, I bet a lot of you have seen magic shows before, but are you a magician, Prove it by typing in this magician's claim. Prove yourselves. If you've ever seen a magician do tricks, you probably have wondered, how do they do it, right? It's not just me. I wonder this. I think about this. Is it magic or are they just highly skilled? I don't know. And if it is magic, where is the magic really hiding? And the magician's claim is, nothing up my sleeve. I got nothing up my sleeve, but you know what? I beg to differ. 37,057 got it right. We should have more sleeveless magicians, right? Because I've seen it up the sleeve. You've got a bird, you've got a rabbit, you've got, I don't know, a long scarf or something. Sleeveless magicians, come on, it could be a thing. As you know, I live here in New York City, but I once lived in the burbs. I've seen grass before, I really have. What is another thing seen in the suburbs? Maybe you live in the suburbs. You see this every day. If you have this, hey, send me a picture and let me live vicariously through your suburban life. Sounds lovely. I've become accustomed to falling asleep at the sound of cars honking all night long. Soothing after a while. But in the suburbs, you would find a white picket fence. Oh, that's so beautiful, a white picket fence. Maybe it's got a little ivy, a little flower on it. 34,746 got it right. And we go on to puzzle 11. A white picket fence, a perfectly groomed lawn, right? A puppy in the yard. This all sounds pretty swell, but I'm from New York City. We've got a lot of honest, tough people here. What is this classic rude question? I used to hear this all the time when I worked in restaurants. It's a classic rude question. If you have to ask this question, you probably just shouldn't have opened your mouth. It's rude. It comes off obnoxious to everyone around you, too. Classic rude question. They want that corner table because they're saying, do you know who I am? Here,
look at
this.
You know who I am? I'm Mo Green.
From The Godfather. Do you know who I am? It doesn't sound nice. No one likes it. I mean, unless you're watching The Godfather, it's a good line. 33,406, I know who you are. And you're a word nerd. Coming off that puzzle, moving on to 12. If you don't want someone to know who you are, maybe make a change, right? Try out a 90s hair trend. Why not? A lot of trends from the 90s are back right now. They are. I haven't seen too much of this, but you never know. Styles always come back. Could be the next hottest thing. And no, this is not the Rachel, though what a lovely callback to last night's Friends game. 90s hair trend. And I'm talking about chunky highlights. You wanna see some? Oh, Kelly Clarkson with those chunky highlights. And if you're saying, what's a chunky highlight? It's literally a chunk of your hair. It almost looked like a zebra that she had there. 8,842 got it right. And 25,583, you just got schooled out of the puzzle on chunky highlights. You know what? It's all right. It's not a flattering look. So if you're out, you're out. It's okay. No one needs to have a chunky highlight. Have you ever colored your hair, though, or gotten anything pierced and you didn't want to show someone? In other words, were you a rebel who had to be so careful? That's also your hint. You have to be strategic because you don't want to upset anyone. You gotta be so careful. Sneaky, right? This is a sneaky way to be. Someone might get. Therefore, we need to be walking on eggshells. Ooh, I'm walking on eggshells. Whoa! You know that song? 17,000. I made myself laugh. 256. Ooh, we're walking on eggshells. Hey, that's the real lyric. And then they just changed it for some reason for the radio. I don't know. I don't know why. All right. I hope you came into this game with high hopes like I did, because I don't want to see any kind of non-ideal outcome. This is something that has a negative connotation, even though it's the outcome that someone set out for. I have the giggles. I'll tell you what wasn't an ideal outcome. That finale of Game of Thrones last night, right? According to Twitter, not an ideal outcome. And the answer is Pyrrhic victory. Oh, it means there was a victory, but you know what? It was devastating for even the victor on that. 9,924 solved the puzzle on Pyrrhic victory. It is almost time, though, to celebrate a real victory right here, because you have officially made it to the final puzzle of the night. 15 puzzles for $15,000. Here we go. We started tonight with over 150,000 word nerds ready to throw it all into the game. And now the hungry survive. Word speed on this last one. Some of you, I see you out there. You're already celebrating a win, but easy there. Come on. We have one more to do. Take it easy there. Maybe you thought you were already a winner. You came in so determined, but it is still unconfirmed until this timer is up. This is for big money, the biggest money we have had yet on this game. The final answer is, don't jump to conclusions! Don't jump to conclusions, but I hope you're jump up and down right now. Jump up and down. We've got 9,844 winners in tonight's season 3 finale of HQ Words. You did it. Woo! Yeah, you did. You won. You won this game. It's late night. Our brains are all funny right now because it's very late, and you won. You pulled it out. Oh, you're going home with $1.53. That is so much money for HQ Words. Are you kidding me? That's amazing. Go buy yourself a can of soda or a really good candy bar. Candy Mars coming in first. NJ Mason, probably from New Jersey, I'm guessing, in second. And oh, our friend Chad 1M in third place tonight for $1.53. I'm so proud of you all. Congratulations. That is the game for tonight. Congrats to all of our winners across the board, taking home some of the biggest prize we've ever had. You win some, you lose some, but hopefully tonight it was a win. I wish we could have an after party together because I've got something up my sleeve. It's not a bird, it's a party. I've been your host, Anna Roisman. Don't you know who I am? No, I'm kidding. But find me here, okay? Send me your Throwback Thursday pics of you with the chunky highlights. You, I see you. I see you out there. You had them. I will also see you back here tomorrow night for the first game of season 4 on HQ Words. Okay, go have an amazing night. Have fun with your winnings. I will see you so soon. Thank you for being here this late with me. I had fun. I hope you did. You made it all possible. I love you so much, word nerds. Good night and goodbye.